we did the review on the S-Fan's dock, and a lot of people kind of lost their minds when the switch was put on its back, which makes sense to a degree. I mean, there are vents back there, so a lot of people automatically assume that if those vents are covered up when placed on, say, a table, then it will overheat. However, when I looked around, I didn't see any actual testing done for this theory. And that's kind of what it is until it's tested. It's a theory. So I thought it's up to me, since I pretty much abuse my switch as it is anyway, to open it up and test with a temperature probe and multimeter. It's done well in the past, and it gives us a decent enough reading. It's not going to be perfect, but it's as good as we can get it until the switch is inevitably hacked and we can have a temperature sensing program built in. So we're going to take the switch apart. I know I have pretty much abused this switch to death, but I've pretty much told her at this point that, listen, this is the last time you're coming apart, and then I won't bug you anymore. Although I did...
I really hope you guys like this video because this is taking forever.
What's up, guys? This is Steve with Tronics Fix. We've overheated the PS4, the PS4 Pro, the PS4 Slim. We've overheated the Xbox One S and Xbox One X, and now it is time to overheat the Nintendo Switch. In order to overheat the Nintendo Switch as quickly as possible, I'm going to remove the back cover, the metal plate, and I'm going to unplug the fan. To do this, I'm going to be using an iFixit driver with a PH00 bit, and then the other bit we need is the Y00. You can find links to these tools in the description below if you'd like to purchase them for yourself, and I highly recommend the iFixit toolkit as it's very good quality. But for now, we're just going to get this done quickly, so that's better. Now we just need to unhook this little ribbon cable right here that connects the fan to the mother. Okay, and here we have the error, and it basically said the console is too hot, so it's turning off. So now let's get the fan back plugged in, and let's see if it'll turn on. So the fan is now plugged back in. I've got the metal plate back on, but the question is, did the overheating mess anything up, or will it work just fine? Thank you.